Okay, dear students, now we will start exercise 3.1. Whatever the concepts we required to do this exercise, we have learnt in the last video or last class. Okay, let us see what questions are giving in exercise 3.1. Okay, you see now, question number one, find the radian measures corresponding to the following degree measures. That means they have given degrees and we have to convert it into radians. We know pi radian is equal to 180 degree. Based on that equality, equation or formula, whatever it may be, we can convert all these degrees into radians. Okay. But what you have to keep in your mind, while converting degrees to radian or radian to degree, if you are converting it to radians, pi can be left like that only, pi, if pi comes. But if you are converting it into degrees, then pi should be converted into 22/7. That you have to keep in your mind. Okay, let us do the question. Okay, let us take first question, first part, 25 degree. See, before that we will write 180, pi is equal to 180 degree, or 180 degrees is equal to pi radians. Okay, radians you can write or downright, nothing is going to happen. Okay, but degrees you must write. 180 degree is equal to pi radian means 1 degree is equal to pi by 180 degrees, sorry, radians. Okay, 180 degree pi radian, 1 degree pi by 180 radian. Okay, let us see one by one. Then number 1, 25 degree is equal to 25 degree is equal to 1 degree is this much means 25 into pi by 180 radian. Radian we will write afterwards. Okay. Okay, now you see 25 180. Five fives are and 536 are. Okay. It will not go. 536, so you have to keep like that only. Now you see pi, if you want you can convert into 22/7, or else you can leave like that only. Why? Because see, we are doing in radians. Finally you write radians. 25 degrees is equal to 5 pi by 36 radians. Okay, radians. See, when you are converted in radians, if pi comes, pi you can leave like that only. But this is not the case for degrees. If you are converting into degrees, then you have to convert pi also. Okay, that you have to keep in your mind. Okay, now this is final answer. You can keep like this only. Let us do second one. Minus 47, 30 degrees. Okay. Minus 47 degree 30 minutes. Okay, before converting it, first you keep in your mind these are degrees, but degrees are in negative minus. Answer will come in radians, but that also in negative only, minus only. That you have to keep in your mind. Okay, and this minus applicable to entire this 47 degree 30 minutes. 47 degree 30 minutes entire negative will applicable. Now 30 minutes, see, we know 1 degree is equal to pi by 180 radian. That means this entire thing you have to convert into degree, then only radians are going to come. What you have to do, this 30 minutes also you have to convert into degrees. You see, 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes. 1 minute is equal to 1 by 60 degree. Okay. Then 30 minutes is equal to 30 into 1 by 60 degrees. That is equal to 30 by 60. That is equal to 1 by 2. 1 by 2 minutes. See, this dash is minutes. Okay, we will do here. Now 30 minutes equal to 1 by 2 degree. 30 minutes is equal to 1 by 2 degree. Okay, this is degree. 30 minutes is equal to 1 by 2 degree means 47 degree plus half degree minus 47 degree plus half degree. Okay, now 94 minus 94 plus 1 by 2 degree, that is equal to minus of 95 by 2 degree. This you have to know. Why? Because if you don't do this all in degrees, then you cannot convert it. Now, negative 95 by 2 degrees are there. Even if you see, 95 by 2 means 47.5. 47.5 means 47 degrees, half degree, 30 minutes. Okay, same thing as now. Now you convert. Now that is equal to, see how we have converted 25 degrees, 25 into pi by 180 minus 95 by 2 into pi by 180, pi by 180. Okay. 5 ones, 5, 45, 5 nines, that means 1 into 9, pi by 2, 5 threes, 5 6, that means minus 19 pi by 72. Okay, finally you can write minus 47 degree 30 minutes is equal to negative 19 pi by 72 radians. This you can write. Okay, like this you have to do the answer. Okay, let us go for third one also. 240 degree. Is equal to same thing like here. 240 into pi by 180. 240 into pi by 180. You see here 0, 0 going to get cancelled. 6 3s, 6 4s. 6 4s, 6 3s. That's all. 4 pi by 3 radians. You write radians. Directly I have written. See here I have made more steps, but here we don't require that much steps. Yes. 25 degree. Here we have started the question answering. 1, 2, 3 over. Now we go for fourth one. 520 degrees. Same. 520 degree is equal to 520 into pi by 180. Here also same. You see 0, 0 going to get cancelled. Okay. 226 by 2 nines. Why? Because 0, 0 cancel. 226, 2 nines. You have to leave like that only. That means, see, 520 degrees are equal to 520 degrees are equal to 26 pi by 9 radians. Radians, R-A-D, like that you can write. Even radians you did not write also, but in question they have asked radian, that is why you write, that will be better. Okay, these are answers for your part 1, 2, 3, 4 for question number 1. Let us go for question number 2. Okay, see the second question. In first question, we have made radians, from degrees to radians. Here they have given radians, we have to convert into degrees. See, in radians only pi will come normally. Okay, pi you can keep like that only in radian. In degrees, pi you should not keep. Now, what we understand? Pi should be converted. See, here they have given, use pi is equal to 22 by 7, but normally in your examination, they don't give. Board examination or IIT JEE. Then you have to take pi as 22 by 7 only. That is approximate value that you have to keep in your mind. Okay, let us see. Before converting, same thing we write. Now, we want a degree from radian. Then, pi radian is equal to 180 degree. Like that, we will write and we will convert it first. Then, we go further. Okay, see how I am writing. pi radians are equal to 180 degrees. Then 1 radian is equal to 180 by pi degrees. See, now we have written here, now you compare this formula first. Why I told you should not keep pi like that only, means if you keep pi like this only, then 180 by pi you may get confused, both are same life. That is why this pi you should convert it into 22 by 7, then final answer is going to come. Pi 180 degree, pi 22 by 7. Okay, both you have to keep in your mind. Okay, let us take first one, 11 by 16. 11 by 16 radians are equal to, see 1 radian is equal to this one, 11 by 16 radian equal to 11 by 16 into 180 by pi. Okay, pi finally we will convert. First you see what is going to come here, you tell me. 290 is 28. Okay, 11 into 90 by 8 pi. Still, yes, still it goes. 2 4s to 45. 11 into 45 by 4 pi. Will it go further? No. Then you take this pi 22 by 7. That is equal to 11 into 45 by 4 into 22 by 7. 7 you can write here. Okay. Well, 22 by 7 means it goes top. Now you see, any result is going to come? No. 7, 4, nothing is going to come. Then you multiply. You multiply all. Okay. 77 into 45 by 88. 77 to 48 into 88. Okay, then you do this. Why you do? You do. Why you make complication? Let us see. 11 sevens, 11 eights. 7 into 45 by 8. Okay, this is going to be a simpler result. 11 eights, 11 sevens. Okay. Now you see 7 45s. 7 fives are 35. 7 fours are 28 plus 3 31. 315 by 8. Now you convert into degrees. How I am doing, you see, 8. 8 4s are 32, that is why 8 3 only you take. 8 3 means 24, 8, 7, sorry, 75. Okay. Then 8 9s are 72. Okay. Then 3 will come. Okay. First you write 39 degrees here. Okay. Now 3 by 8, you have to convert into minutes. 3 by 8 into 60 minutes, that is equal to 180 by 8. Okay? Again, you do for 180 by 8. 8 2s are 16, 20. 8 2s are 16, 4. 22 minutes. Okay? See, 22 minutes are there, but still seconds are there. 4 by 8. 4 by 8 or 1 by 2. 1 by 2 minute. 1 by 2 minute. See, 1 minute is 60 seconds. Half minute, 30 seconds. You need not do again. You directly write 30 seconds. Now, final answer is this one. 39 degree, 22 minutes and 30 seconds. Okay? 11 by 16 radians is equal to this much. Now degrees so you don't write. Why? Because after degree, minutes, seconds also have come. Okay, now we go for second part, this one. You see here in question, negative 4 radians have come. Negative 4 radians. Then answer also will come in negative only. Negative degrees. That you have to keep in your mind. Okay. Entire answer you have to make it in negative. Okay. Okay. Let us do. Minus 4 into pi by 180. Sorry. 180 by pi. 180 by pi. You see now nothing is going to calculate. That is why you have to convert it into
22 by 7. That means, see, minus 4 into 180 by, this is 22 into 7. Okay, by 7, 7 goes top. Okay, now you see, 11 it goes, 11. 90, 11. Minus 4 into 7 into 90 by 11. Is it okay? Okay, 2 11s, 2 90s. That's all. Okay, now you see, minus 4 into 9 7s are 630 by 11. Okay, now minus of 4 0 0, 4 3s are 12. 4 6 are 24 plus 1 25 by 11. Okay,
minus negative 25 by 20 by 11 degrees. You convert into further.
Okay, now what I am writing, you see here negative I have already put. Okay, now you see 25 by 20 11. 11 2s are 22, 3 32, again 11 2s are only 22, 100, again 11 9s are 99, then 1. 1 by 11 fraction is there. First you take this 229 degrees. Okay, now 1 by 11 degrees only, but you have to convert into minutes, fraction. Okay, 1 by 11 into 60, that is equal to 60 by 11. 11 5s are 55, then 5 will come. 5 also, 5 by 11 also fraction. First you take this 5 as minutes. 5 minutes. Now 5 by 11. 5 by 11 into 60 is seconds. Here minutes, here seconds. That means 300 by 11. 300 by 11. 11 2s are 22, 80. 11 7s are 77. You stop. 27 seconds you can write.
You understand now how it has come. You see, final answer negative has to come. Negative 4 radians, negative 229 degrees, 5 minutes, 27 seconds. Degrees, minutes, seconds. Okay? Now, let us go for third one.
Five pi by 3 radians are equal to,
see, these are radians, we are converting into degrees. That means 5 pi by 3 into 180 by pi. Okay, now you tell me, pi pi are going to get cancelled, 360 times it goes.
5 into 60 by, that's all, 5 into 60. Why? Because 360 pi pi, 5 into 60, that is equal to 300 degrees.
You have to write only 300 degrees, that's all. Okay?
Okay, now let us go for fourth one.
Fourth one, you see, 7 pi by 6.
Okay. 7 pi by 6 is equal to r radians. Are equal to 7 pi by 6 into 180 by pi.
Here also you see pi pi going to get cancelled 630 times.
7 into 30. 30, that means 210 degrees.
You understand, na? Okay, now we finished the second question. Let us go for third question. Okay, see the question here. A wheel makes 360 revolutions in 1 minute. Through how many radians does it turn in 1 second?
Okay,
see, we know 1 minute is having 60 seconds. Okay, see, it is making 360 revolutions in 1 minute, means in 1 second less. Less number of revolutions it is going to make. That you have to keep in your mind.
Let us write.
Why? Because finally answer is asking in second. Okay. Number of revolutions in minute. You write first this one. Number of revolutions in minute. Minute means 1 minute. That is equal to 360. Now you write number of
revolutions in second. That means 1 second. That is equal to 360 by 60. That is equal to 6. Okay? You understand na? How it has come? Okay. Now, what is asking? How many radians does it make? Okay. See, one revolution makes how many degrees? We first take degrees, then we will convert it. One revolution makes degrees is equal to 360 degrees. One revolution, complete revolution, like circle. One revolution, complete revolution means one circle. One circle gives 360 degrees. 360 degrees it is going to make. Okay. Then one revolution makes radians. One revolution makes radians is equal to 360 degrees means how many radians? 2 pi radians. That's all. Okay? 2 pi radians. Why? Because pi is 180. 2 pi is 360. 2 pi is 360. That's all. One revolution is making 2 pi radians. In 1 second, 6 revolutions it is making. 6 revolutions. Then how many radians it will make in 1 second? Same thing. 6 into 2 pi. You write it. Number of radians in 1 second is equal to 6 into 2 pi. That is equal to 12 pi radians. This is your final answer. That's all. See, first they have given in minutes. You convert it into seconds. 360 per minute means 60 per 6 per second. Why? Because divided by 60 you have to make. Okay? Then again, see, one complete revolution make 360 degrees. 360 degrees should be converted into radian. If it is converted into radian, means 2 pi radians will come. Okay, 1 second, 2 pi radians are there. In 1 second, 6 revolutions are there. 6 into 2 pi, 12 pi radians it is going to make. That's all. Let us go for fourth question. See the fourth question. Find the degree measure of an angle subtended at the center of the circle of radius 100 cm by an arc length of 22 cm. You see, we can find angle in radians. Why? Because see, we know that theta is equal to L by R. L is arc length, R is radius. Here both they have given. Arc length they have given, radius they have given. Then theta we can find. Theta will come in radians. But he is asking angle in degrees. That means after radians, that we have to convert into degrees. Like that we will do. Okay. Now, we write the formula. Okay. Now, first of all, what is the data they have given? You write arc radius of the circle. Radius of the circle, comma, R is equal to 100 centimeters. Okay. Arc length, that's all. Arc length, comma, L is equal to 22 centimeters. See, both should be in one unit. 22 centimeter, 100 centimeter. Both are in centimeter. That you have to keep in your mind. Or else you are not going to get correct answer. Okay. Now, angle in radians. Angle in radians, comma, theta is equal to L by R. This is our standard formula. Okay. L by R means L is 22 by 100. That's all. Okay. Now 11 by 50 radians. Further it don't go. 11 by 50 you have to keep like that only. Now you see 11 by 50 are radians. But he is asking in degree. Then you convert it into degree. See here. Theta in degrees. That is equal to 11 by 50 radians into, see, pi radian is equal to 180 degree. 1 radian is equal to 180 by pi. 180 by pi. Okay. 11 by 50 into 180 by pi. Okay. First you cancel this one. See, 0, 0 going to get cancelled. That's all. 11 into 180. No, 18 by 5 into 22 by 7. Is it correct? You see? Okay? Now see, this you can make 11, 2 11s, 2 9s, yes. 11 into 2 9s, 7, 5 will be like that only, but this is going to become 11. Why? Because 11, 11 going to get cancelled. That is why I have made like that. Now you can see 63 by 5 will come. You understand? 11, 11 got cancelled, 63, 9, 7, 63 by 5. See, these 63 by 5 you have to convert into degrees, further minutes or seconds. Whatever it may be, if directly it doesn't come, then you have to convert into minutes also. Okay. You see now I am doing it like this. You see 63 by 5, 5 ones are 5, 13, 5 twos are 10, 3. 3 by 5 fraction is there, but let us take a 12 degree. See, these are all positive only, no negative. 3 by 5. 3 by 5 into 60 minutes, that is equal to 180 by 5. 180 by 5. 5 threes are 15, 30. 5 6 are 30, 0. Now further don't go, 36 minutes, that's all. 12 degrees, 36 minutes will be the answer for this question. Okay? Now let us go for 5th question. Okay, see the 5th question now. In a circle of diameter 40 cm, that means now it has given diameter, then we can convert into radians also. Sorry, radius also. Diameter by 2, radius r. 40 cm means radius will come 20 cm. The length of the chord is 20 cm. You see here, chord is telling. Chord means you have to cut in sector. In sector, you have to get a chord. That I will show you how it is there. Find the length of the minor arc of the chord. Okay. Now you first write the data. What they have given. Okay. Diameter of the circle. Diameter of circle, comma, D is equal to 40 centimeter. Now we want radius. Radius of circle, comma, R is equal to 20 centimeter. Okay. Now length of the minor arc is asking, but he has given chord, chord length. Chord length. Chord length is equal to 20 centimeter. See, for this no symbol is there. But what is asked, length of the minor arc means L. Okay, arc length, comma L is equal to question mark. This we have to find. You see, now, L we have to find, R is there, but we don't have theta. Theta, if you are able to find, then we can find, what is the formula? See, this is the formula. Theta is equal to L by R. We can find theta in radians. If we find theta in radians, then L we can find. Why? Because R into theta, L. L is only is asking. But rather than theta, they have given chord length. By chord length, how we can take theta, we will see. Okay. Now you see, this chord and all comes means how to draw that figure. O is the center, okay? You see, this is a sector. This is called sector. Sector, okay? But in sector, AB straight is the chord length. This is 20. Straight, straight length. But AB curved length also is there. Curved length. We have to find curved length is L, AB, curved length. But straight length they have given 20, chord length, this is chord length, 20. Okay? Now one logic is there. You see, radius of the circle 20 has come. That means, see, this is center, this is radius only, no? Up to 0 to B is 20. 0 to A also 20. You understand, na? Then, by logically, if you see 20, 20, 20 means this is an equilateral triangle. You forget about curved. You see only triangle. Triangle, if you see, this is equilateral. Equilateral means all 60, 60 degrees will be there. 60 degree, 60 degree, 60 degree. Because chord length they have given 20, this is 20, this is 20, radius 20, radius 20, then 20, 20, 20, equilateral triangle, 60 degrees will come. The 60 degrees are in, theta is in degrees, then you have to convert into radians, so then you can do length also. Okay, let us write. As in figure, angle, comma, theta is equal to 60 degree. Theta in radians is equal to, see, 60 degrees means pi by 3 radians. Okay, see, some standard figures directly you write, you need not make again conversions or calculations. 60 degrees means pi by 3, 360 degree means 2 pi, 180 degree means pi, 45 means pi by 4, okay, 30 degrees means pi by 6, like that directly you can write. Pi by 3 radians, see, now radians you are having theta, r also you are having, you can find L. Now you can take L is equal to r theta, r into theta, that is equal to, r is how much, 20 centimeter into this one, theta is pi by 3. Okay, now 20 pi by 3, okay, see, the sixth question. If in two circles, that means two circles they have given, arcs of the same length, see, both arc lengths are same, that means L, not L1, L2, L. Subtend angles of 60 degree and 75 degree, see here, they have given angle in degrees. We may or we may not have to convert into radians, why? Because ratio we have to do, that we will see. Theta 1 is 60 degree, theta 2 is 75 degrees. At the center, find the ratio of the radii. See, when we want to R1 by R2, we have to find the ratio of radii. Radii means radiuses. Okay? Radiuses, plural. Radiuses. That radiuses, we will write radii. We don't write radiuses. R1 by R2, we have to find. But R1 by R2, when we are finding theta, normally, when we are finding ratio, theta will be, let it be in degrees also, we can do. We need not convert into radians. That you have to keep in your mind. Okay, let us write. See here. First, you draw some figure for understanding. See, this is some bigger circle. Why? Because angle is bigger here. One is at 60 degree. Another one is at 75 degree. Okay, now you see, this is theta 1, this is theta 2, but arc length is same, L, but radius different, R1, R2. You understand, na? See, we know these only, theta is equal to L by R only, we know, but theta is in radian. Theta 1, theta 2, why? Because two angles are there, different. But same arc length is mentioning, that means L. L1 is equal to L2 is equal to L. R1, R2 are different. Ratio of radii, R1 by R2 we have to find. Okay, ratio. Let us write first data. Arc lengths of the circles. Arc lengths of circles is equal to L1 is equal to L2 is equal to L. Okay. Now there is no L1, L2, L only you have to take for both. Now angles in degrees of circle. Circles is equal to theta 1 is equal to 60 degree, theta 2 is equal to 75 degree. Okay. Now these two are in degrees, that you have to keep in your mind. Okay. Radii of circles is equal to R1 and R2. See, R1 and R2 both are different. Now you see, theta 1 is equal to L by R1, theta 2 is equal to L by R2. Is it correct? Why? Because theta is equal to L by R. But here L is standard. Theta 1, R1. Theta 2, R2 will be going to come. Okay. Now with this, you convert into implies. you convert into radius. R1 is equal to L by theta 1, comma R2 is equal to L by theta 2. Okay?
Yes.
Okay, now see ratio. He's asking na ratio, ray of radii. Ratio of radii, you write like this. Ratio of radii is equal to R1 by R2. That is equal to L by theta 1 by L by theta 2. That is equal to L by theta 1 into theta 2 by L.
Is it correct? L by theta 1 by L by theta 2 is going to become L by theta 1 into theta 2 by L. If division, this one, multiplication, then it is going to reverse
fraction.
Okay, now you see L going to get cancelled. Theta 2 by theta 1. Theta 2 by theta 1. Now you write theta 2, theta 1. See, because ratio, you need not convert into radians. You can write degrees only. Okay, now theta 2 is 75 by 60.
Okay,
5 15s 5 12s 5 15s 5 12s. Okay, again 3 5s 3 4s 3 5s 3 4s. Okay, now finally we can write ratio is 5 is to 4. Okay, you write ratio of radii, ratio of radii 5 is to 4. This is your answer. You know now how it has come. Okay, now let us go for 7th.
Okay, you see now the 7th question. Find the angle in radian.
Okay, now theta we have to find, through which a pendulum swings in its length. Pendulum means like this. Pendulum means it is rotating like this, like clock. Okay, 0, then A, then B. Okay, like this it will rotate. What he is asking? He is asking us to find theta. Theta normally it comes in radians. He is also asking in radians only. Okay. Now, if you completely rotate, it is going to become circle. Okay, now this is radius. OB or OA is radius. Okay, but radius is here. Pendulum length. Length of the pendulum is radius. Arc length they have given. Let us first study the problem, question, then we go for answer. Find the angle in radian, this is angle, through which a pendulum is swinging. See, swinging means not rotating. Rotating means completely it will rotate. Swinging means not rotation. Up to certain degrees only it will go and come back. Length is 75 cm. That means pendulum length is 75 cm. That means here this length you can take it as radius. 75 cm. This is radius. Radius of circle like you can take. Tip describes an arc length of 10 cm, 15 cm, 20 cm. See, three separate questions we have to tackle. When it is 10 cm, see this arc length, AB, arc length. If AB is 10 cm is one question, I am going to write here. See, this may be 10 cm or this may be 15 cm or this may be 21 cm. In three cases, separately you have to find this theta. Well, 10 cm means less angle is going to come, theta. 15 means 10, more than 10 but less than 21 angle will come. 21 means more angle will come. To make 21 cm more, 10 less theta. Okay, conceptually you have to understand this one. Okay, now only two figures are there, you write, then we find. Anyway, direct question only. He is asking us to find in radians only. Okay, see, length of the pendulum, that is equal to radius, you have to take. See, length of pendulum, comma, R is equal to 75 cm. This you have to take as R, this as L. Okay. Now, arc length, comma, L is equal to 10 cm. See, this is for first one. For first part, I am doing 10 cm. Okay. Now,
angle in radians, angle in radians, comma theta is equal to L by R, that is equal to 10 by 75, that is equal to 5 to 515. I think we can keep it like that only. Okay, 2 by 15 radians. You understand now how it has come? Okay, now go for second one. 15 centimeter arc length. Again you write arc length, comma L is equal to 15 centimeter. Again you write angle in radian, comma theta is equal to L by R, that is equal to 15 by R 75. That is, this length is standard. Okay, 1 by 5 radian. Okay. Okay. Now go for third one, 21 centimeter. Arc length, comma L is equal to 21 centimeter. 21 centimeter arc length is there. Then angle in radians, comma theta is equal to L by R, that is equal to 21 by R is 75. Okay, you see here 3 sevens 3 fifteens, it will go 325, sorry, you write 3 sevens 3 25, 7 by 25 radian. You understand na? This is a solution for your seventh question, question number 7. In the next class we go for 3.2. before 3.2 exercise, what are the concepts are there, that we will see. With this we have finished your 3.1 exercise. Thank you very much.